Listen, that was all right. That was all right. But y'all, it's the church anniversary.
That's right.
A celebration. And we're celebrating Pastor Mike Jr.'s release. I need us to make some crazy noise. Let's go.
Hallelujah. Listen, I got a special announcement.
Okay.
I want to serve notice to the devil that hell loosed another one.
Another one.
Yeah.
Hell lost another one. Listen, you we just finished baptizing almost 200, right? 200 people gave their life to Christ. Now, that's a good place to give God praise right
there.
In the room and online, giving their life to Christ, making that decision to walk with Jesus. And y'all know this weekend is so incredible. I kind of come out the gate because this is the hottest album. It's number one Christian gospel album, also made to number two on all genres, the number two album as well. Y'all make some noise for Pastor Mike Jr.
Yes.
Impossible. If you don't have it, what are you doing?
It's giving
us something for everybody on here.
Listen, it absolutely is. You know, we've been in the series talking about the courage to commit.
Yeah.
If you're a part of CTC gang, I need you to make some noise if you have the courage to commit.
We're
seeing happen in Pastor Mike's life is the byproduct of what happens when you tell God yes, when you tell God that I'm all in, when you say, for God I live and for God I die.
Oh, my God. And you're seeing it here, the manifestation of that.
Yeah.
Because Pastor Mike Jr. has been committed. We see him. He's one of the most committed, hardworking people I've ever been blessed to be around. And so to see what's happening, people all over the world now are celebrating what he's doing. And just this, family reunion. We had a family reunion yesterday. It was incredible to see people coming from California, Florida, North Carolina, Louisiana, Texas. If you're not from Alabama, make some noise right now.
And look, if you are watching online, we want you to go ahead and drop your city, drop your state, drop your country flag in the comment. Look, we don't have a whole lot of rules
not
here in Rock City.
We got one.
We only got one. What is it?
Let's say it together.
You cannot rock alone.
Tag Lottie Dottie and everybody telling us about to be an impossible party. They do not want to miss. So share, like, tag, send it to your friends. Let them know it's going down in Rock City.
Yeah, and even as we're talking about this impossible piece, we've been hearing from a number of folks just what it means to believe God for the impossible.
Yeah.
And one place that we're able to have those conversations is through Devo
Energy!
Look, if y'all watch Devo Energy Monday through Friday, can we just celebrate those that wake up super early in the morning?
Yes.
Yes, God.
The Bible says
early in the morning
will I seek thee. That's being committed.
Yeah, that is.
That's being committed.
I heard that we got some special guests who are highly committed in the building.
Yep.
So I'm going to do a quick roll call.
Let's see what we got.
Some of the Tuesday crew in the house.
Okay, what Tuesday
bring
crew?
Them out, bring them out.
Bring
make
them
some
out.
Noise
Elder
for Elder Candace.
Oh, okay,
look,
shirt.
We got another one. DJ Khaled has released another one anointed.
Another
I
one.
Need y'all to make some noise for Minister Carlene in the building.
Let's go.
And then, of course, we want to give a major shout-out to our Wednesday crew, which is Experience Department. But after Hump Day, we got Thursday. Can y'all make some noise for Minister Aisha in the house?
Now, wait a minute.
It's the glasses for me.
Now, see.
It's the glasses for me.
See, Devo Energy be 7:21 a.m. if you don't know. Are y'all modeling or y'all bringing the word today?
Because
y'all fly. It's the swag for me. Custom-made impossible shirt, sweatshirt.
Yeah.
Come on with me. I love it.
She
y'all make some
play.
Noise
she
for these beautiful
play.
Women of God. Awesome, powerful women of God.
Wait, there's another one. Because after Thursday,
we
got Freedom Friday.
Uh-oh, let's go.
Make some noise for
Freedom
Crystal
Friday.
Light, y'all. Look, y'all, this is the Devo Squad. Of course, we're missing a few, and we'll hear from others in just a matter of moments. But look, y'all, it's the season of the impossible.
Yes.
We're believing God for what eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, nor has it entered the hearts of men. So when you think about what it means to believe for the impossible and to see the impossible, what does that mean to you, Minister Aisha?
For me, in Mark, it says that with men, this is impossible. With God, all things are impossible. Woo. And it's on all things for me. You understand? Yeah. Not the small, not the large, but every little thing. God is concerned about us, you know?
What about you jumping out of the candy?
So listen, the definition for impossible means can't be done, won't occur. So this is my thing. If I got God, it will occur.
Okay.
It can be done.
Okay.
So everything is possible because I can do all things through who strengthens me. So it's possible, all right?
Jesus, what about you? Jump in there, Carlene.
To me, it being impossible means taking the risk.
Yeah.
This is the year to take the risk. Woo. So that you can reap the reward. If I was you, I'd just reach up and grab my reward because I'm taking the risk.
Yeah, that's good. Wait a minute. Look at your neighbor and say, take the risk.
Take
the risk because we're reaping the reward. Jump in there, Crystal.
And for me, it's all about faith and belief. God wants nothing more but for us to believe him and have faith. He wants us to have faith the size of a mustard seed.
That's right.
Not doubt the size of a mustard seed. Doubt and destiny do not mix.
That part is that for me. Can y'all make some noise for our Devo Energy crew?
Amazing. Come on, y'all can do better than that. Make some noise. At home and in the room.
Again, weekday 7:21
yeah.
on Facebook and YouTube.
But everybody around us winning, right?
Period.
Everybody around us winning. And speaking of winners,
we
got some state champs in the building.
Yeah.
We got some state champs. Ramsey High School.
Yeah.
State football champs. Y'all make some noise for them, y'all.
Give it up for Ramsey High School.
Come on. And we got the cheerleaders.
Give it up. Give it up. Give it up. Give it up.
It's the team spirit for me.
All right. We got the coach. We got our principal. Uh-oh. Praise God. That's all right. Look, let's go ahead and get our coach and principal. One thing that I appreciate about Rock City is that we know that our mission is to love God,
love people,
and make a difference.
Absolutely.
And our pastor is super intentional about making sure that we don't just talk about it, because we know that faith without works is dead.
Yes.
So we're talking about it and we're being about it.
Absolutely.
And so we wanted to find a way to celebrate our young people and their accomplishments. So PMJ has pledged more than $20,000. Yes, God.
Y'all don't know where they're going.
Brand new uniforms. Yes, for Ramsey High School.
Wow.
So I'm gonna give you this. We got Coach Jackson. Coach Jackson.
Come on, Coach Jackson.
Real quick. So look, I'm gonna give you this. Hold the money. You gotta hold the money now.
Hold
the blessing. And so when you think about what it means to invest in our young people, and what partnerships look like when we're doing this kingdom work. For a moment, talk about the importance of that. And what does this seed now mean for Ramsey High School and BCS as a whole?
For us, we're just thankful. We're so thankful to God. You know, they try to say that we can't have prayer in schools. We can't have that. But if you're in school, we take church with us. So this is just a blessing. I'm so thankful for our kids. I'm so thankful for our principal. I'm so thankful for this church that pleads and does everything they can for our community. And that's all we want to do is mold these young men to be great leaders in our community. And we give God all the praise.
Come on, come on. Look, and we have our principal real quick. Dr. Walker, we're celebrating you and the work that you're doing. Talk a little bit about what this investment means for our young people.
The investment is like sowing a seed.
Yeah.
And every day we come to work, the faculty and staff and administration of Ramsey make sure that that seed is nurtured, that seed is watered, and that seed will grow every day. And so we are excited, beyond excited.
Yeah.
And I have to say, when Pastor Mike put out the song Big, I did not understand what he was talking about. But when I look at this check, I'm looking at big.
Yes.
And so I pray big on Rock City. I want these numbers to double, not just in money, but in membership, but in saved souls for Rock City Church. And I just pray for Pastor Mike and his family. because big means something today. If it has never meant anything. And Ramsey High School, let's just say thank you together. One, two, three. Thank you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Look, you can tell she does this professionally on the side. But can we celebrate Ramsey High School? Y'all make some noise. Finish this sentence for me. And it's going to be
big.
Thank you all so much.
Brand new uniforms for the football team.
Yes, God.
I can't wait to see the swag next year.
They brought everybody.
Yeah, everybody got everybody.
I got a really big team.
Oh, we talking team?
Okay, that part. Absolutely.
And it goes to show, Pastor Mike, he talks about having a heart for the city.
You're right.
And being the hands and feet of Jesus, not just having church, but being the church.
Yes,
being
God.
An example, and to see as he continues to pour out and give. That's why.
Yeah.
I know he say he don't like to beat a dead horse, but that's why I love the support that we're giving to him toward his project Impossible.
Absolutely.
If you don't have it, make sure you download it, stream it, put it on repeat. Yeah. Not just because it's Pastor Mike, that's one reason, but because it's an incredible, amazing project from start to finish.
Listen, you said it some weeks ago, no smoke. You said there are no skips.
No skips.
And when I tell you the album has been on repeat, I'm waking up doing Mr. McClure. I'm going to bed singing Amazing. I'm in the car shouting Impossible.
Yes.
So what would you say is one of your favorite singles from the new album?
Man, I've been on Able lately.
Okay.
I love Able. My God is Able. That's one of my favorites. The whole album is incredible. But Able, and I think when I talk about how God is Able, there's a young man that's a part of our church, part of our ministry, who's been here and been such a blessing, Rod Turner. And I'm believing that God is able to not only do it exceedingly, but
Come
he's
on.
Going to do it.
That
and
part.
I want you to check out a little bit of Rod's story right here.
My name is Rod Turner, and I've been here at Rock C since 2015. I've known PMJ since probably 2008, 2009. I met PMJ actually at Miles College, was having a youth night every Monday night. I go in there, he meets me, and I start playing for him, and we were just joking around, and I played a track I did, and he was like, man, that's what's up, boy, you're gonna be dope. For so long, I was always keeping in touch and everything like that. Then God brought up an opportunity. I was able to come to Rock City in 2015. And I had been traveling on the road with PMJ, and PMJ's God, like that. You know, I've been working with him and doing everything, wrote big with him and everything that's been happening. And I remember being on the road with him a few times, and I would just get tired all of a sudden, just tired out of nowhere. So I went to the hospital for a regular checkup. I just wanted to make sure everything was okay. They called me that day after I did my blood work. They called me back and it was like, hey, I'm sorry to tell you this, man, but you're gonna have to come back like right now to the emergency room. I was like, you know, everything all right? He's like, man, well, your kidneys are at 2%. Your kidneys are literally at 2% function. And if we don't get you here now, that your body can do anything at this point. December 2021, found out I needed a kidney. Get back to the hospital, they tell me, we're gonna have to put you on dialysis right now. All I can remember is just God put me in this. I didn't feel like, man, you're gonna die. Like, nah, it was more so like, stay calm, like cool, like it's gonna be good. Oftentimes, sing at Rock City and in those moments of worship, we have so many melodies and stuff that we do that people don't even realize that stuff stick with you. And I can remember Impossible. I can remember when we first did it in church. I can remember Big and all those melodies and stuff that we would come up with. And all I can remember, you did what no man could. I can remember those things in my head. I was like, man, you know, I'm good, man. I done been around too much ministry, too much word. You know, I done seen God work miracles in my parents, my family, my mom, my dad, everybody. Like, I'm believing God for the impossible. I'm believing God that he's going to do exactly what he said he was going to do. Just take care of me. I believe that, you know, somebody is out there, you know, with a kidney for me. In a perfect situation, perfect scenario, perfect blood type, everything that matches. I do believe that somebody's out there that has a kidney for me. So when I was doing research on me and figuring out everything about my body, I realized that my blood type is actually O positive. I'm a perfect donor for anybody else, but it's hard for me to find a donor for me because you have to be O positive to actually be a donor for me. So in that process, I'm learning now that even though that's one of those situations that I can't control, that's still something for God to do. And that's how I'm believing God for the impossible. But I know God is doing it on the other side of this. I'm getting to a point now where I'm understanding, be grateful for life, man. Be grateful for life, health, and strength. And you just don't know when that day come where you got to kind of sit down and chill. I just encourage people to, even if you don't know, like, your blood type, start there. Go find out what your blood type is. Go find out, you know, as much as you can about yourself, because you just don't know. There's a lot of people out there that you can help. And there's a lot of people that you can give freedom to and life to. But I definitely appreciate Rock City. I appreciate PMJ. Appreciate, you know, everybody that has been supporting me throughout this process, me and my wife, you know, my kids. They've been super supportive. I believe that God is going to do what he's going to do in 2023 for me. And I'm looking for a lot of other miracles to come out of this. And I'm really believing God for the impossible. And I thank you all for your support, your love, every band member, every choir member, everybody that has supported me, all my coworkers, the Rock City staff, everybody that has given so much love and support in this situation, because it's not been easy. But yet, I don't feel depressed or down or anything about this. I'm uplifted. I'm good. I feel good, and I'm ready for this to be the story of 2023. It's gonna be me and my story, man, my kid.
Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you know that God is still a healer,
he is.
If he's still a way maker, look,
still.
Y'all too quiet. If he's still a deliverer,
yeah.
I need you to shout like you know that you know
that, you
that
know.
God is doing the impossible.
It's amazing because Rod, he's still been in all the rehearsals.
Yeah.
He actually produced and played on Impossible, put that together. So how can you do a song like Impossible and not believe that God's going to do it for him as well?
That's
so Rod, we are praying for you. We love you, brother. And we know that God is already getting it done. So we celebrate you in a special way. I heard we got another special guest in the building.
Listen.
It's going crazy on church anniversary.
Word on the street is we got a lot of folks pulling up today to celebrate 13 plus years of ministry, of real, true impact.
Yeah.
And this is also a brother who continues to defy the odds.
Absolutely.
He continues to make things that man seems to be impossible possible. And so I need y'all to make some noise and join us in welcoming our Mayor Randall Woodford.
Woo!
Yes, sir. Listen, Mayor Woodford, we want to thank you so much for taking time out of your schedule to be here with us today. So look, our theme is impossible, right? And we know that you've seen a lot of impossible things done in the chair that you sit in. So just kind of talk about the magnitude of this moment and even just your relationship with PMJ.
Rock City Church, make some noise.
Woo!
Listen, everybody. It's humble. I'm very, very humbled to be here. This is exciting. The energy in here, 13 plus years of serving Christ, serving our God, Savior, and putting on not only for the city, but what you all do to give back to this community. PMJ is a true leader. Shout out to Rock City. But listen, I've been listening to the album.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
The album is dope. The album is fresh.
Okay.
I agree.
And most importantly, what I did today, y'all had the instrumentals on. The instrumentals.
Yeah.
Now you know those beats are fresh. Love PMJ, love the vocals, but the production is dope. So I got something to say to everybody.
Okay.
I got something to say.
Okay.
For 13 years, Rock City Church, God has been good. For 13 years, Rock City has been counting blessings of thousands. For 13 years, Rock City has been winning. For 13 years, God has been so good to Rock City. For 13 years, God has covered Rock City with one prayer.
Well, come on.
For 13 years, God has allowed Rock City to do amazing things in our community.
Preach.
For 13 years, Mr. McClure has been a leader in our city. For 13 years, Rock City Church has looked through the windows and pierced the souls of its members. For 13 years, God has allowed Rock City to be able to do giveaways, pay down medical debt, and so much more in this community.
Yes.
For 13 years, Rock City Church is still here. And for 13 years, God has done the impossible for Rock City Church. Love God, love people, and make a difference.
Woo! I love it. Come on,
listen, man. I know we got people watching from all over the world. But I just want to say, your mayor could never. Look, I need y'all to show some love for Mayor Woodfin. But look, again, we got a lot of people pulling up. We got a lot of people pulling up. This next guest, I want y'all to make some noise for Pastor Mike Jr.
Everybody on your feet, make some noise.
Up on your feet, up on your feet. Yes, God. Listen, real quick, real quick. In a society that oftentimes pushes us to compete, we see how you all have been collaborating. Yes, sir. So will you all just talk a little bit about just the beauty in collaboration and what's possible?
First off, it's our anniversary. Somebody make some noise. Yeah. I mean this, man. I absolutely honor and salute our mayor. And I mean this. I believe what God is doing in Birmingham. Always remember that Birmingham was the place of reconciliation and change. America did not change until Birmingham put America on notice. And I want to prophesy what God is doing through our mayor, what God is doing through Rock City Church, a Pastor Beavers, a MK, the legends that we stand on the shoulders of. I'm going to see who can get excited. America is about to wake up again. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, and it's going to be bars, boy. I'm excited, man. How y'all feeling tonight? Everybody feeling good?
Listen, we are feeling so amazing. We got people here from New Mexico.
Wow.
We got people that have drove in from Florida. I met a couple from Delaware. So when you talk about Birmingham, all eyes once again are on this city. Yeah. And I know there was an interview that you did a while ago how what was once was called Birmingham is now called
Birthingham.
Birthingham. Yeah. And so real quick, because I know y'all got to head out, there's some people that are believing God to birth some things in this season. So bring the camera just a little bit closer. Can you speak to that woman? Can you speak to that man? Can you speak to that family?
Okay, I want to bless somebody real quick. This isn't my sermon, but I want to help you right here. That whenever you give birth, there are two ways you can give birth. It's called a natural birth or a C-section. Now, a natural birth means that you push that baby out, but any real mother understands that even though you push it out naturally, you can't push it out without some pain.
That's good.
And there's seven people listening to me right now who've been pushing through some pain. I'm gonna see if you've been listening.
Yes, sir.
Not only am I consistent, but I am what? Persistent. But I didn't come to preach to the natural birth givers.
Okay.
I came to preach to three folks who had to give a spiritual C-section. That you've had some cuts, you had some wounds, you had some scars, but you can declare, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. God did not bring me this far to leave me right here. Somebody shout, I'm still.
Make some noise.
P.O. 5.
Mayor Woodfin, thank you.
If you receive that, give God a praise.
Jeez. He didn't bring us this far. Just to bring us this far. Yes, God, listen. Once again, we got a whole lot of rules. We ain't got a whole lot.
Not a lot.
But there is still time to share, right? Yes. So share this with everyone that you know, because that was just a sneak peek, y'all.
We just getting started.
It's only going to go high. Every round going higher and higher. So share the link. Let people know it's Rock City anniversary, and it's going to be big.
Well, let's go to Devo Energy.
Devo Energy.
Make some noise. Devo Energy.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Man.
Good morning. Well, Pastor Hollis? Come on now.
There we go. Hey, they tried to hold a real one down, but they couldn't. If you're excited to be in the building, make some noise. No, hold on. That sounds sort of like Rock City.
Right.
But not like exactly like Rock City, because it's church anniversary.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it's release weekend of Impossible.
Yes.
And you're in downtown Birmingham.
Yes.
And you're at Rock City. And this is Devo Energy live.
Let's go.
Absolutely. Family, I'm so excited that you guys are here. Pastor Mike had this brilliant idea
that has become known as Devo Energy, what, 2 years ago?
Three.
3 years ago.
3 years in.
We've been doing this for 3 years now. Where's all my Devo Energy family? Can y'all make some noise in the building?
Yes.
Elder Tiffany, Pastor Leslie, Julian is here with us as well. Guys, we talk all the time about the impact that Devo Energy has, how we'll be, you know, in an airport or traveling somewhere, and literally people will scream out of their car window.
Yes.
Exactly like that. So really quickly, y'all talk a little bit about the impact that Devo Energy has had and what it's meant to you guys to be able to be a part of it.
Oh, wow. I mean, just the impact, and not only Devo Energy, but just this ministry as a whole. I mean, we're literally sitting in a prophetic declaration. Yeah. I mean, I thank God that he has allowed me to not only just watch what he has done with Rock City, but I get to witness it. What I mean by that is, when you watch something, you're watching from a distance, but God has blessed me to get firsthand. So I get to witness all the things that Pastor Mike has declared, yeah, all the things that God has done. So Devo Energy, literally, and I say it every Thursday, you guys are literally walking, talking testimonies of the goodness,
wow,
of God.
Wow, that's absolutely amazing.
Man, it is crazy. So one of the little secrets about the panel that we have up here, Elder Tiffany and I are the oldest members on stage right now. So, like, literally to see this, this for us is manifested dreams, manifested
full circle moment. Yeah.
Full circle moment. Like, literally this morning when I text Pastor Mike, I was like, I have been blessed to do life with you for 13 years. And not only has, like Elder Tiffany said, I haven't watched, but I've witnessed. I've seen front row the wins, the losses, and just seeing you guys, it's overwhelming in the best way.
Amazing.
So for me, it has been submitting, truly, to submitting to God. Because when I first came, I got the call saying, hey, would you join Devo Energy? We'd love to have you a part of it. And in my mind, I said, you want me? you want me to get on there?
Yeah.
Talk? But really, I just had to pray about it and said, God, not my will, but thy will be done. And to see the impact that Devo Energy has had, and like you said, people coming up to you and saying, you know, I remember you from Devo Energy.
Yeah.
And what that has done also is added another level of accountability.
Absolutely.
Wow.
That now I have to really, now I have to walk in what I'm speaking.
That's so
now
cool.
I really, because I don't know who I'm encountering.
Yeah.
And so the things that I'm saying on Devo Energy, I really have to walk in that spirit of humility, that spirit of walking in another level of faith. Yeah. So that's what it's done for me.
Wow, I love it. One more time, y'all make some noise, man, in the building, online. Our family from around the country is here. Guys, Pastor Mike's brand new album, Impossible, is taking the world by storm. Come on, y'all make some noise, man. So listen, we wanted Impossible to sort of frame our Devo Energy conversation this morning, and I had a scripture that popped to mind when I thought about the word impossible. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 17, verse 20, because you have so little faith, truly I tell you, if you have the faith as small as a mustard seed, I'm preaching to somebody already, you can say to this mountain, move from here and it will move. Watch this. And nothing will be impossible. There's some Bible readers in here somewhere. I think I'm gonna say that again. If you have the faith the size of a mustard seed, you can speak to a mountain and tell it to be moved, and nothing will be
impossible.
You didn't say it like you believed it. And nothing will be
impossible.
All right, I'm gonna give you one more chance. And nothing will ever be
impossible.
So listen, I think one of the major things about Pastor Mike and the music that he creates is that it's more than just songs. We were talking about this in the office the other day, Julian, and I believe that God gives Pastor Mike more than just songs. I believe he gives him prophetic declarations. Because a couple years ago, we had the audacity to start telling everybody that it's gonna be That's a prophetic declaration that no matter how small the situation or the circumstance, I feel like preaching for some reason,
come on now.
That you're looking at, that you have the ability to speak to it and say, even though it doesn't look like it's going to be big, even though it doesn't feel like it's going to be big, that when God gets involved, it's going to be big. And so when I think about impossible, I really look at situations and circumstances in life, and I think we have to say that even when it seems like it's not gonna happen, that what seems impossible to us is still possible to God. All right, so here's the big question. Y'all ready? Here's the big question. What are some biblical examples that come to mind when you think about impossible?
I couldn't help but go straight to Genesis. Genesis 18:14, when God had told Abram and Sarai that they would have a baby, and Sarah laughed. Don't that seem like some of us?
Yeah.
God give us a promise, but we laugh at it. But the scriptures say, is there anything too hard for God? Yeah. In other words, do you think it's impossible to do
it? I can't take it.
Nothing is impossible for God. And the Bible said, and by this time next year, you'll be holding that thing I promised you. So it's some people out there that's believing God for the impossible.
Yeah.
And God said, by this time next year, that thing I promised you,
come on,
you'll be holding it.
Come on now.
Is there anything impossible for God?
Somebody better make some noise in the building. That was a whole word for somebody. Pastor Leslie?
Y'all going to put me behind that seat?
Go ahead. You got
I should have picked a different seat. Right. Julian, let's swap.
Is that right?
No, seriously, when I think about the impossible, my mind immediately went to Elijah versus Baal. And I thought about when they said, no, the God who answers by fire shall indeed be God. And then, you know, they take the offering and Baal people do what they do. And Elijah said, okay, bet, let's do this. Let's see who really God. So he takes it, he prepares it, he says, okay, now I need you to pour gallons and gallons and gallons of water on top of it. And then while Baal's people doing what they do, he said, cry a little louder. Maybe he's sleeping. He don't hear you.
Wow.
And after a while, he said, you know what? Let's go. And then he has them to pour the water. And all of a sudden, he says, no, God, I need you to stand up and show who you are. And sure enough, God answered by fire. And he said, you know what? The God who answered by fire is indeed God. So for me, it's just a reminder that God is God in the midst of every circumstance.
On,
like Pastor Hollis said, no matter what it looks like, no matter what it feels like, God is God.
Julia? You ready, man?
I'm going to give the mic to the crowd.
Yeah.
But no, my mind, I'm sitting in this place of God doing the impossible through man and how he uses man to bless others. And so my mind immediately went to Acts when Peter and John rolled up to the man who was lame at the gate called Beautiful.
Come on, man.
And so when he's talking to him, he's asking for alms, and he says, look, Peter looks at him. The man looks back at him, and Peter says, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have I give unto thee. In the name of Jesus,
come
of
on,
Nazareth,
man.
Get up and walk. And so what that tells me is that I'm saying in this season of my life, God, use me.
Yeah.
God, you give me the power. Let me speak like Peter did. And when whatever needs to be declared, silver and gold, I may not have.
Yeah.
Resources, I may not have. Access to the legacy arena, I may not have.
Yeah.
But I got Jesus.
Yes.
So whatever I have, you got it, God. You got it.
Man, I absolutely love that. I was really struggling with this question, y'all. And I stumbled upon Acts 2:24, all right? I want to read this real quick. I think this is good. This is what it says in the New International Version. But God, who raised him from the dead, freeing him from the agony of death because it was impossible for death to keep its hold on him. The writer of Acts is literally describing the fact that when Jesus died on the cross and was placed in the grave, that death wanted to keep him.
Come on.
The devil thought he had won. All right, let me help you understand. Your supervisor thought he had the upper hand. The coworkers who don't like you thought it was over for you. But when you've got real faith in God, it's impossible. Even a dead situation, I don't know who I'm talking to,
amen.
But can we prophesy to everything that looks dead in our life and let the devil and hell know that with God, nothing is impossible. Y'all make some noise. All right, I think we got time for one more. We got time for one more. All right, real quickly. Let's think about Impossible, the album. All right, song titles. All right, song titles. I want you guys to really quickly, so imagine, all right, everybody do like this. Everybody do like this. Everybody do like this. All right, everybody. All right, you riding in your car. All right. Now, depending on how tall or short you are, you might need to scoot your seat up a little bit. All right, even online, I need you to do like this. All right, you in your car. All right, y'all ready? Yeah, you in your car? All right, yeah, Julian, you got to lean a little bit. Come on now. All right, so some of us lean, some of us, all right, we in the car. All right. Now, you've got Impossible playing, okay? I need to know what your favorite song is, all right? What are you playing in the car, all right?
No, when I tell you I don't have just one.
Yeah.
He had me at Hello.
Come on.
When I tell you every song from the Hello, get you.
Yeah.
Hear me. Couldn't judge a book by his clothes. I'm so good. Hear
yeah.
me. If loyalty was a crime, I wouldn't do no time. I mean, like, he had me at Hello. From
it.
Impossible to Still Here, which, of course, his mom singing.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. And First Lady tore it up.
Come on
to
now.
To Tamla Man. I mean, he had me Hello. It's not awesome. A song that, no skips.
I love
no
it.
No skips.
I love it. Pastor Leslie?
See, Elder Tiffany be cheating, man. Like, I'm with her. I do have multiple favorites, but my actual favorite is Not Jesus. And you know, I can remember the first time Pastor Mike let me hear that song. He said, Leslie, you're going to really appreciate this. You're going to like this. And I was like, I love it. And every time I thought it was going to get cut, I'm like, hey, what about Not Jesus? That was me, y'all. Every time. Anytime I thought they were like, no, we ain't gonna, mm-mm. But I love that song just because it's like, no, we have all these different versions and all these different types. And, you know, you get into the circles, you hear about Black Jesus, White Jesus, this Jesus.
Love
but
it.
It's like, no, just let them see the real Jesus.
Yes, I love it. Julian, what you got, man?
So I'm sitting with two.
Okay.
I'm rocking with two. So Good. So who's rocking with So Good? Everybody rocking So Good? So Good. I mean, every time I hear it, I'm just,
Yeah, so good.
It really does. He reached down. Like when I hear that, I'm like, man, it's powerful.
Yeah.
But Abel,
Abel
is getting with
you. Oh, yeah.
Abel is really good. So, and really to look at everybody coming together on that song. So Adia, I mean, I've been listening to her music since like 2012 in Huntsville.
Wow.
Like many. So in Huntsville, Da Vinci, shout out to Da Vinci and just doing the work that he's doing. So, everybody there collectively, that song has just been blessing me. So those are my two.
Love it. Listen, thank y'all so much for coming and hang out with us. Can y'all make some noise for Devo Energy? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. We're so excited that you guys are here. Are y'all ready for an incredible, amazing experience today at Rock City? All right, we're going live to the screens, and our experience is starting in 5, 4. 3, 2.
Hey, what's up, Rock City? We are here at Legacy Arena. We just finished sound check. I believe today is about to be absolutely incredible. Hundreds have already been baptized. People are walking in the building now. We're tired. We've been here going on now. It's almost, 9 o'clock? We gave away over 3,000 t-shirts already. God has been moving. But guess what? We are about to go higher. Wherever you're watching from, wherever you're watching from, put your city in the comments right now. Because I firmly believe that what God is doing in Birmingham, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has it entered the hearts of men, the great things God got in store for you. So are you ready? Nah, I'm talking to the people in the room right now. Are y'all ready? Now, you can't be ready praising God like that. Do a road check real quick. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, I didn't come to the Legacy Arena to be cute. I came because it's a party. Listen, today I need the electric slide when I come out. We finna have a good time in God. I may scream. I may shout. I tell you what, you didn't praise God because I've been too contemporary. Let's go old school. This is the day. Y'all better wake up. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Somebody shout like God's about to show out today. Are y'all ready? Let's do one big countdown since we all together. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Happy anniversary!
Seat, I need you to pray. We want to invite God's presence in the place up there in the balcony. Somebody watching me on live, just grab somebody's hand. Can you stand up and give God some praise? Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your presence. We thank you for what you're about to do in this place right now. We invite your presence in this place, God, and we thank you for moving like never before. We're praying for souls. We're praying for souls. We're praying for souls. Let somebody come and see you in this place, God. Your word says how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity, God. And we here in unity, and we are thanking you for what you about to do in this place. We pray miracles, signs, and wonders. We pray that somebody get healed from cancer. We pray somebody get healed from diabetes. We pray somebody get healed from a mental disease. In the name of Jesus, God, we thank you for your Holy Spirit. Let your anointing fill this place in the name of Jesus. God, we cast all our cares upon you because you cared for us, God. We thank you, God, that we overcome the enemy. He's like a roaring lion seeking who he may devour. But God, we thank you that he come to steal, kill, and destroy. But you come that we have life and have it more abundantly. So God, have your way, God. Do the impossible. Cause us to win. And God, we thank you that you are still here in the name of Jesus.
All right. I hope y'all ready to praise him. Are y'all ready on this side? I need to see your hands like this. Let's go. We're going to take it back. Here we are. Let's get on one accord. Leave all your problems on the outside. To be consumed with the Holy Ghost fire. Open up your mouth and lift the name of Jesus higher. Say,
are you ready?
Come on.
Your blessing.
Are you ready?
Are you ready?
For your miracle.
For your miracle.
For the change that come from the enemy. How utterly destroyed when the praise. Your greatness.
the name of Jesus. Power in your name. There is power in the name of Jesus. Power in your name. You say
there is power in the name of Jesus.
Shout if you know there's only one name that has victory. What is that name? I call him, oh my God, I don't want to get in trouble when I say this. I call him because I trust him. You've called every other name that you can think of. But I need you in the next 30 seconds to open your mouth and shout the name of Jesus.
Somebody lift your hands all over this place. As if you're saying, God, I'm turning every situation over to you. The name that's above every name, the name that's above pain, the name that's above your issue. Can you open up your mouth and begin to worship and call the name Jesus all over this place? Listen, if you call your name, ain't nothing gonna happen. But if you can find a way to open up your mouth and call the name Jesus, things begin to happen. So you say,
even though I can't see,
I can't feel your touch.
I can't feel your touch.
Somebody say, God, I trust you.
I will trust you, Lord.
Anybody love him today?
Oh, I love you so much.
Though my nights seem long.
My nights may seem long.
Sometimes I felt like I was by myself.
I feel so alone.
God, my trust is in you.
My trust is in you.
Somebody say, I surrender.
I surrender.
Let's give it to him, y'all. So many.
So many painful thoughts.
Travel through my
mind.
And sometimes I'm on my knees praying. I say, God, how in the world I will make it through it? Let's stand together, say, it's not easy for me. Sometimes the pain in my life, the stuff my family don't even know I'm going through, makes you sick. Say, God, but I still trust. I just need to know that God, you're here. Come on, let's tell them through the tears.
Through the tears and the pain.
Through the heartache and rain.
Through the heartache.
Family, anybody besides me ever had to cry? Nobody knew what you was really feeling. But God was right there with you through the tears.
Through the tears and the pain.
Come on, through the heartache and rain.
The heartache and rain.
Listen, family, somebody in this room right now is going through a storm. And the devil's been lying to you, said there's no way you're going to survive what you're in right now. But I wish at Legacy Arena we can make the devil out of a lie. And somebody can lift your hands and say, God, I still trust you. Say, God, I still believe that some kind of way you're going to make a way. You're going to do the impossible. Because God, I will. I trust you. It's not easy, but I trust you. See, it's hard. But God, I still take it up. Say, I will. I had my heart broken. I made mistakes. But I trust you. It seems like you're not here. But God, I still, I'll trust you. Now somebody throw your hands up and say, oh God, I just lost my job. I had my heart broken, God. You ain't know how you was gonna make it, but God didn't let you down there.
And then somebody thought about last year when you almost gave up on yourself, but God was right there. If he didn't let you down then, the same God, the same God is going to bring you through. I wish somebody would shout. He's still powerful. He's still a miracle worker. He's still a healer. Without the music, glory's hitting this house right now. Without the musicians, ain't no praise team at your house. I want you to open up your mouth and shout for the glory of God. Come on, somebody say, I'm still praising. I lost some stuff, but I didn't lose my shout. I lost some fake friends, but I didn't lose my praise. I will bless. No music. Some of y'all say, well, James, I'm not going through nothing. Well, can you shout for that sister on your row trying to raise them babies? Can you shout for that brother that's trying to get a job with that felony? I speak by faith, favor over felony. I speak that God's going to still do the impossible.
I don't know what you're waiting on, but I believe that was a prophetic declaration that is some stuff headed your way, but it's going to be according to the level of faith and trust that you have in God. I gotta say that again, because some of us, we haven't always had somebody who we can count on to get it done for us. You don't have a rich uncle that you can call and ask him to pay for school. No, some of us know what it feels like to have to trust and believe God for the impossible. Can you take 30 seconds and can you put something in the atmosphere that lets the devil and hell know that you still trust God, that you still believe God, that you're still walking in anticipation of what eyes have not seen, what ears have not heard, because we trust it.
Devil, let me down.
If you don't mind, grab your neighbor hand to your left or to your right. Because sometimes it's one thing to praise God by yourself.
Yeah.
But it's another thing when you have a praise partner. The Bible says at midnight, Paul and Silas began to pray.
Wow.
And their prayers turned into praise. And as they began to praise God, the chains began to fall off of them and the doors began to open. I'm gonna give you about 30 seconds right now to begin to praise God with the person whose hand that you're holding. And we're declaring that chains are falling off and doors are opening. No more depression, no more anxiety, no more fear, no more lack. God, right now, move how you wanna move. Do what you wanna do. And we declare that as our praises are going up, peace is coming down. As our praise is going up, favor is coming down. Give God your best praise in the room, somebody.
Raise it up.
So, Father, we trust you with all our hearts. We love you. We thank you for 13 years. Thank you for sustaining us. And we say in this moment, we give you our full heart and we create an atmosphere of faith for your presence to move like never before. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody shout amen. Come on, give God praise.
Give them the best praise that you can all over the building. Listen, family, on behalf of Pastor Mike McClure Jr., Lady J, the entire family here at Rock City, we want to welcome you to the greatest church in the world. We are...
Hold up, that was weak.
Okay.
Let's try that one more time. We're going to do it like Kevin Hart, Uncle said, say it with your chest. Look at your neighbor and say it with your chest. I want to shake the entire city of Birmingham. Are y'all ready? We are... There we go.
Come on, one more time, make some noise. Listen, this is our greeting period. Do me a favor, can you high five somebody real quick? Throw your arms around somebody, love on them. Let them know you're happy to see them here at Rock City. Even online, those of you that are online, find somebody in the comment section. Just speak to somebody, let them know you're happy to see them. I'm giving air high fives from the stage. Air high fives to everybody. Air high five, air high five. Yep. Well, listen, family, my name is Hollis Thomas. I'm privileged to serve on the executive leadership team here at Rock City.
My name is Pastor Darius McClure. I'm just a humble servant.
Yes, sir.
I'm jealous. I miss Devo energy.
Oh, yeah.
But I still got my Devo energy. I'm sorry. I had to get it out. But we have so much happening here at Rock City. We've been on 21 days of praying and fasting. Did anyone enjoy those 21 days? Who was faithful during the cool down? But we have something important coming up because now we like to start the year in prayer.
Yes, sir.
And then we launch into purpose and ministry. So what's happening this month?
Listen, on the 26th, you can take your seats. On the 26th, that's the fourth Sunday in February, we are gearing up for the reboot and return of Pathway to Purpose,
yes.
All right?
Come
We're
on.
Excited about that. And here's what's so crazy about that, Pastor Darius, is that now there will be an in-person option.
Absolutely.
As well as online. So if you want to register to be a part of that, you can text P2P to 28950. Again, that's P2P. To 28950. I'm super excited about it.
I'm so excited about that because what we've done is we've condensed it into a one-day experience to where if you're in person or online, you can complete Pathway to Purpose in one day on Sunday, February 26th at 1:30 immediately after the Sunday service.
Yep.
And this is a process to where you can go through healing, learn about why you're saved, and get plugged into purpose. We're so excited about it. Somebody shout P2P.
All right, listen, sit back, relax, and prepare to receive Rock City TV News.
Out.
Rock City, I need y'all to make some noise. Yes. Listen, do you know what today is? Of course you know by now. It's our anniversary. Yes, we are celebrating years of countless communities being served, lives being forever changed, and souls being saved. Hell lost another one. We just witnessed it firsthand. More than 100 people were baptized. That's a good place to clap. Drop some hand clap emojis in the chat as a sign of their courage to commit. CTC, if you're watching on live, just drop CTC in the comments. If you're sitting in the sanctuary, go ahead and elbow your neighbor and ask them if they have the courage to commit. And so look, if you missed this today's baptism, no sweat, y'all. You can sign up for our next one by texting ROCKNATION to 28950. And after you've taken that step, maybe you're saying, look, I'm ready to come off of the sidelines and get into the game. You can do that by being a part of Pathway to Purpose because it is back. Go ahead, pull out your phone and mark your calendar for February the 26th. Text P2P to 28950. Learn about all of our various ministry opportunities and how you can get involved today. Somebody say today. And speaking of today, y'all look, PMJ's album is available right now for purchase. Yes, God. Look, if you are in the sanctuary, I need you to go ahead and pull out your phone. Pull out your phone. Ms. Jenkins, you can pull your phone out. We're going to wait on you. Pull out your phone and purchase. purchase PMJ's brand new album entitled The Impossible. Y'all, look, we are seeing God do the impossible. Miracles, signs, and wonders. So many testimonies have been pouring in from all across the country. You can purchase PMJ's album today. Because get this, come in just a little bit closer, Dre. Look, he is currently number one on gospel charts and on iTunes. But look, we don't believe God for the ordinary. We're believing God for the extraordinary. That he is going to be number one in the world across all genres. Look, I'm hyped, y'all, because I've seen our man of God soul. I've seen him stir. And I just believe that it is our winning season. Let's go. Winning season, I win. Because everybody around me winning, yeah. And look, you also want to look like a winner as well, praise God. And you can do so by picking up your merchandise on your way out. You see the swag. You see how we, you know, we swagging it out for Jesus and whatnot. So look, be a part of this movement. Be a part of this mission. Because you want to walk into this new season knowing I'm possible. But look, before we take a look forward, let's take a quick look back. This all started, y'all, at the Fairfield Civic Center. PMJ oftentimes tells a story about how he set out 1,000 chairs and only 10 people showed up. But he had the courage to commit. And eventually, God then shifted our ministry to the LR Hall. Now again, Pastor Mike just told us a couple of weeks ago how him and a few others would get there super early in the morning and literally have to sweep up, like y'all remember the old school push brooms. They would have to do a push broom through the space, cleaning the floors that were full of drug paraphernalia and alcohol and other substances, right? But again, the man of God had the courage to commit. Just drop CTC in the comments if you're watching on live. So from LR Hall, we then shift to our Forestdale campus, and we've seen God continue to do the impossible through that location. It has really now served as a hub and a resource for the communities that are surrounding that area. Shout out to Rock City Prep that operates Monday through Friday out of that space. And so that just speaks to our intentionality and now investing in the next generation. But look, y'all, it's been crazy because even at our Forestdale location, we've been busting down through the seams on Sunday doing a number of different services. So that's actually when we then shifted to this multi-site type mode. Y'all remember, we had Rock City East, Rock City West, Rock City North, Rock City, we were rocking from all directions. And then God led Pastor to place us in a more centralized location. Can you guess what was next? That's right, Botwell Auditorium. You see the footage, y'all. Thousands of people filled the room, God. Like, it's just been insane to watch God and see God work and move through our ministry. And so not only have we filled auditoriums, y'all, but we have filled the bellies of those that are hungry. We have filled their cabinets. During the pandemic, we got an opportunity to provide food boxes. We provided masks. We've showed up at schools and provided school supplies. We've given away thousands of dollars of free gas, of groceries. I mean, utilities have been paid. School tuition has been paid. When you give to Rock City, you don't just give to a ministry, but you truly give through a ministry. And get this, y'all. We believe that the best is still yet to come. Rock City, so look, y'all know everything we do what? Big, that's right. Last year, we welcomed Kirk Franklin, and it was crazy. We were electric sliding, we were vibing, the energy was on 10. So this year will be nothing different. Get ready and welcome our very special guest. Wait a minute. Who's the guest? Y'all, hold on 1 second. Y'all. Y'all, I'm so sorry, Pastor. I'm so sorry to interrupt. But who's the guest artist?
for this year?
Oh, it's finna be crazy. I'm in here signing all of these CDs. Look at this table full of CDs.
That's crazy.
Back in the day, I would have said, I got bread. But I hear eggs cost so much, I can just shout, I got eggs. I got eggs. Oh, we signing these. It's going to be crazy. The last year was her friend.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
James, who we got? That's your department.
What was a couple? I didn't know who we finally decided. We was talking about like three different.
You didn't
we
never did.
I honestly thought we was narrowing it down.
How are we
going to
have a party with no...
I didn't get the invoice or anything.
Yeah.
So you mean to tell me we done gave away 3,000 free t-shirts. School board is happy.
Yeah.
Ramsey happy.
Yeah.
Mayor Bay here.
Yeah.
That's what they call him on Twitter. Mayor Bay. We got the whole mayor here.
Yeah.
And no artists?
Honestly, I thought we was trying to sign from the two we talked about.
Like I said, I got the email and I was going to confirm.
The budget.
I don't know.
We need somebody. Okay, so we need somebody who will shut it down.
Oh,
yeah, I mean, yeah, you saw what happened last year. Yeah.
Turn the whole arena into a party.
Yeah. Absolutely. That's why,
Shake the city.
Yeah.
Got hits.
Yes, oh, hits. Sure. Number ones.
Yeah. That's way.
Do they need Stellas?
I think so. Right? It's our anniversary. It's our anniversary. It's our anniversary.
We know of anybody?
Man, the only one I could think of is back-to-back artist of the year.
Come on.
I know. Wait.
They left his home.
Found me, don't know how to be.
fighting, yeah. I never had no one to stick beside me, yeah. And when it's cold, I know he got the fire. You made a way.
You made a way.
Pound it away, yeah.
You keep on blessing.
Every day. Devil be mad, yeah. You know I stay in my bag, yeah. Everybody around me blessed. It's already mine.
It's already mine.
You know the devil be mad, yeah. You know I stay in my bag, yeah. Everybody around me blessed. I got it, I got it. You got it, you got it. We got it, we got it. It's already mine.
Already mine.
I got it, I got it. You got it, you got it. We got it, we got it. I don't want it. I don't want you to miss it. But you're going to have to claim it for yourself. I need you to look at somebody around you and whatever you believe in God for, look at them and tell them, I got it, I got it.
I got it, I got it.
Okay, I thought y'all came to have a party today. I thought y'all came. I got it, I got it.
I got it, I got it.
I tell you what, split the room in half. Face that way. Let's go. Say, we got it, we got it.
We got it, we got it.
Say we got it, we got it.
We got it, we got it.
Say we got it, we got it.
We got it, we got it.
Say we got it, we got it. Let's go,
we got it, we
let's
got
go,
it.
Let's go. Every time I turn around, he keep on blessing me. Every time I turn around, he keep on blessing me. Every time I turn around, he keep on blessing me. Every time I turn around. It's called a prophetic declaration. I'm going to say it again. It's called a prophetic declaration. Grandmama said if I couldn't say a word, I'm going to talk to y'all. Grandmama said if I couldn't say a word, look at your neighbor and say, well, Grandmama, I'm taking it to another level. That's a 360. Every time I turn around, he keep on blessing me. Time I turn around, he keep on blessing me. Here we go. Make sure your track's glued in. Keep on blessing.
Keep on blessing.
Keep on blessing.
Keep on blessing.
Yeah, yeah.
Keep on blessing.
Yeah, yeah.
Keep on blessing.
Keep on whoop.
Keep on blessing.
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 chapter 103 starts out by saying, I gotta preach and sing. Y'all don't mind if I do both of them, do you? Psalms chapter 103 is enough to tear the whole church up. Because there are two people sitting on your row. One of y'all want a blessing. But then it's two of y'all crazy enough to say, God, if you don't give me nothing, put Psalms 103 on the screen. It literally says, bless the Lord. I'm in the wrong church today. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Now, somebody shout bless. I need you to say it like you mean it. Shout bless. Now, bless on the surface means to fall to my knees in worship. But there's a secondary definition of bless that tore me up this morning. Because bless derives from the word euglios. Euglios, where we get our American word eulogy. Eulogy means to speak well of. Uh-oh, I'm finna separate the real from the fake. Because there's two of y'all standing right there. One of y'all full of mess and another y'all full of a message. Michael, one of y'all full of mess. All you want is tea. Baby, tell me the tea. I'm finna have church. I don't need tea when I got oil. Slap your neighbor, high five and shout, I'm too blessed to be messy. I'm too blessed to be. Somebody shout bless. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Watch this. It means to speak well of God. Now, I miss old school church. Because old school church, grandmama didn't have screens. Grandmama didn't have dancers. They had one microphone. I'm in the wrong church. And everybody in the choir wore the same thing. What was what? A robe. But they had something in church that we need to put back in church called testimony service. Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
I said, praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
First, give an honor to God, who's the head of my life, to the pastor, saints, and friends. It's good for us to be here. I'm finna run. And they would take turns, Michael, telling everybody in church how good God been to them. I don't have all day for you to grab the microphone, but for the next 60 seconds, I need you to tell somebody in your section everything God has done for you. Come on. He woke me up this morning. Called me in my right mind. Activities in my limbs. Come on, you got 30 seconds. Testify. 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 You don't know how to testify? I once was lost. You can sit your bougie self in here all you want to, but if you knew if it was nothing but the grace of God, I once was lost. I need a praiser to get excited, but now, I don't know who I'm preaching to, but all of 23, all I'ma say is, but now, shake your neighbor and shout, but now, didn't have no money, but now, didn't like my job, but now, didn't get along with my family, but now, you ought to slap somebody high five and shout, but. Testify. I'm just a little Negro from Ainslie who had enough faith to tell the devil, you thought you could kill me, but yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I ain't scared of no enemy, I ain't scared of no building, I ain't scared of no debt, I ain't scared of nothing. Why? If God be for me. Santiago, give me a little bit more up here. Hear me. Y'all ain't gonna testify. So can I testify? Now, in testimony service, no matter what I say, you gotta go crazy. Because if grandmama said, I ain't have enough money for my medicine, but I went to the pharmacy. And some kind of, it's something about that some kind of way. So if I be transparent, y'all not gonna judge me? If I had to testify,
I will testify like
my family is saved, our mother's pain, I'm walking in freedom.
Yeah.
Haters keep talking, but I keep on walking with lies, I don't need them.
Woo.
My body is healed, my mind is whole, I'm full of the joy of
like a Quavo, stacking all these blessings like they Legos. I put my right hand on the Bible. When the blessing came, I screamed, Michael! Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, you know. I'm counting my blessings. Counting my blessings. Counting my blessings. I need y'all to count with me. Y'all ready? Yeah! raised Baptist in a sense, right? I was raised Baptist in a sense. And somebody asked me what style of music I got. I said, I just sing the songs my mama and my grandmama have sung. I just interpret them different. See, if I went across the sea, they may not speak my language, so I need an interpreter. And see, I ain't being crazy. Right, my grandma would say, woke up this morning with my mind. Yeah, stayed on Jesus. Y'all grew up in a church like that too? I woke up this morning with my mind. Stayed on the Lord. I woke up this morning with my mind alone. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Grandmama
said she woke up this morning and she felt blessed. Right. So what's wrong with me saying, woke up this morning, I'm blessed. And folks calling me crazy, saying that ain't gospel music. All I'm telling you is that when I went to my refrigerator, it used to be empty. Now I can say, food on my table, I'm blessed.
Clothes on my back, yeah, I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. If you don't dance, you ain't nothing but a hater. Everybody dance, go! Woke up this morning, I'm blessed. Food on my table, I'm blessed. Clothes on my back, yeah, I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Woke up this morning, I'm blessed. Food on my table, I'm blessed. Clothes on my back, yeah, I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I woke up this morning, I'm blessed. Food on my table, I'm blessed. Everybody around me winning. Yeah. Everything around me winning.
Yeah. I know it.
Y'all better help me. Come on.
You go in. Everybody around me winning. Everything around
say
me.
Say it
winning.
Again.
I'm going. You go in.
Tell your neighbor you gotta dance with.
Everybody around me winning.
Yeah.
Everything around me winning.
Say it.
I'm going. You go in.
I need y'all help.
Everybody around me.
Every hand lifted, y'all ready? Let's go. Woke up this morning, I'm blessed. Food on my table, I'm blessed. Clothes on my back, yeah, I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Woke up this morning, I'm blessed. Food on my table, I'm blessed. Clothes on my back, yeah, I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Woke up this morning, I'm blessed. Food on my table, I'm blessed. Clothes on my back, yeah, I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Woke up this morning, I'm blessed. Food on my table, I'm blessed. If you know it's your winning season, I need you to get outside and say, it's my
winning season. Winning season.
Somebody around you, tell them if you knew who you were standing next to. Ain't it crazy when people look at you like you ain't got nothing because you ain't flashy? But if they knew what you had on the inside, go ahead and bust a 360 for everybody on your row. If you knew like I knew you was
7 of y'all ought to pull out your phone, and the next post you post is a subliminal to every ex-friend, every ex-relationship. You ought to just tell them, if you knew like I knew you would say. Hear me. David says in Psalms 103, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget none of, this will make you run, of the benefits. Now everybody with a real job should have got excited right there. Not a real job, but a job with benefits. Because some of the hardest jobs I ever worked on didn't come with no benefits. And hear me when I say this, I hope you can handle this. He says, bless the Lord, put it on the screen, hold my soul, and forget none of his. Okay, I never forget. I'm studying at Yale Divinity. I'm at Yale Divinity, and my professor says something that I never forget. He says, Michael, that word benefits don't mean what you think it means. I said, what you mean, sir? He says, because we modernize words. You think benefits means blessings on top or connected to your paycheck. Help me. Benefits literally means, watch this, camel. Okay, Pastor Mike, I want to shout, but I don't understand what a camel is. In the desert, they didn't have a plane. They didn't have a train. So the camel was known as the automobile of the desert. I hope you can catch this. And the camel is important because it can go forever and it don't require a lot of substance. Y'all miss what I just said? So somebody shout benefits. What you're telling God is, God, I thank you because you've given me way more than I gave you. What are his benefits, Pastor Mike? You ought to just shout when I get to you. He pardons my iniquities. Put that scripture up there. They got to see that. He pardons my iniquities. Now, our mayor and our councilmen are here, and they understood pardon way quicker than we did. Pardon does not mean I'm innocent. You don't get a pardon for being innocent. You get a pardon when you've been found guilty. Now, there are two types of guilty people. I'm finna find you. One of y'all guilty and you didn't even do it. Life just happened. I ain't preaching to you. I'm preaching to the three of y'all who crazy enough to say, oh, I did that. I need you to reach over that hater and high five another neighbor and tell them I'm not as innocent as I look. It's some stuff I done did, some places I done been, some things I said. Truth be told, I don't even know how I'm still here right now. And I'm scared to say this, and I know we at the arena, but if I was at old school church, there's a word that if you say it real quick and take out running, it was nothing but the grace. I'm gonna give you 30 seconds. I need you to shout for grace. I need you to shout for grace and mercy. That he reached beyond your faults. He pardoned my iniquities. Here's the one that messed me up. He healed all, Dre, my diseases. Now, I got members in my church with cancer. I got a brother on the piano right now dealing with high stage cancer. Hear me? And we gotta find him. Gotta find him a kidney. Kidney disease. We gotta find him a kidney. But here's what I'm crazy enough. God, I'm believing you for a kidney. Watch this. But I still think you got enough to fix a kidney. All right. I don't need everybody to shout. I only need three of y'all to shout who got a negative doctor's report. Then when you went back, the doctor said, I don't really know what happened, but God is still in the healing business. For the next 60 seconds, I need you to shout for healing. Speaking of a sick brother, in the book of Hezekiah, Hezekiah's minding his business. Mama Hezekiah's minding his business, and out of nowhere, the prophet walks in and says, get your house in order. Watch this. Surely you will die. But here's what messed me up. Oh, God, I said I wasn't going to cry. It wasn't enough for the prophet to tell him he was going to die. He hit him with two negative words. Look at the scripture. For you are about to die, semicolon, you will not get well. All right, Michael, seven of y'all might take out running. He gives him a word that attacks every prayer he could possibly pray. He said, just in case you pray to live, I'm telling you, you're going to die. And just in case you pray to get better, I'm telling you, it's not going to get well. Okay, I need somebody who's good at math. How many negative words do you see? Two. Then the scripture says, Hezekiah face the wall. Now, I'm finna mess y'all up. I need this section to help me preach. Y'all gonna preach to the people in the middle. Are y'all ready for this? Okay. Some of y'all can't get better because all you're doing is looking at people who telling you what can't happen. Okay, watch this. When I say turn, I need y'all to face the wall. Okay, here it is, turn. Uh-oh. Behind you is every negative word, every doubter, everything they said you would never accomplish. Hear me? Now turn again. Boom. Watch this. Not only do he turn, y'all don't see what I see. He gets a negative word and he does what? If my people who are called by my name, watch this, would just humble themselves. See, some of y'all want to be big and bad. Pastor Mike, how you gonna get to the next level? And Hezekiah, two negative words. He just prays one prayer. Just one prayer. And I don't know what you're dealing with. Somebody came in here on the verge of giving up. I just want to testify, all it takes. I've heard stories of what you've done. Testimonies of the battles you've won. I searched for solutions and I couldn't find one. So if you don't do it, if you don't do it, you want to know what I discovered in all my years of living? Whenever you are in a situation that can't nobody you know fix, that's proof you in a situation that God wants to handle.
Yeah.
Michael, hear me. And what if God said, I'm gonna put you in something your mama, your friends, your man, and your woman can't fix? Here it is. Hold on, right. Because if they fix it, you're gonna have to testify softly, testify about them. And God says, ain't nobody gonna get my glory but me. And I don't know who I'm preaching to, but I want to prophesy that God's about to do the one thing you need him to do. Do for me what you did for Daniel. Close the mouth. Do for me what you did for the woman who was bleeding. Yeah. Do for me what you did for Abraham and Sarah. Do for me what you did for Jabez. I need you to.
Tell your neighbor, I need you to give me a little room, cause overflow is about to hit my.
double, you triple, enlarge.
Enlarge my territory.
I am just
one prayer away.
Yes, I am.
Just
yeah.
One prayer away.
You have not.
You have not.
Cause you have not.
Cause you have not.
You have. Know what the pandemic did? It took away our ability to touch and agree. And I don't know where your comfort level is, but I just need you to grab somebody close to you and tell them, I got enough favor for the both of us. I got enough praise for the both of us. If we touch and agree, by faith we receive. If we touch and agree,
by faith we receive.
If we touch and agree,
by faith we receive it. By faith we receive it.
If we touch and agree,
by faith we receive it.
If we touch and agree,
by faith we receive it.
If we touch and agree,
by faith we receive it.
What's my prayer 2023? My prayer is. Shout for you, but I can't want it for you. Tell your neighbor you by yourself for the next 3 minutes. I need a worshiper to lift your hands and just shout, do it for me. Your praise ought to match your expectation. Do it!
Do it for me.
Yes, God. Do it for me.
Do it for me.
I need to fill this room with worship right there. I don't need another piano no hit. I don't need another lyric song, because music is good, but it's a prayer that can shift everybody's life in this room. I need every prayer warrior to begin to pray. I need, if you got a tongue, go into a tongue, because God's shifting something in your faith. Do it for me. Hezekiah prays. Sit on the one, do it for me. Stay there. Hezekiah prays. And I want you to catch this, and seven of y'all gonna catch it. Please, Lord Jesus, remember how I served you faithful. Rock City, I'm going to see if you catch this. Remember my commitment. All right? I served you faithfully with wholehearted devotion. And that's my problem with the church. Because you live in a nice house, got a good job, and drove a nice car. You read the Bible from your present posture.
But when you properly harmonize your hermeneutics with relevant homiletics, you understand that you cannot read a scripture from your present posture. You have to embody what the writer meant. Michael, so since your bill's paid, you sitting here like, put it on the screen, please, Lord. Since your children ain't crazy, you sitting here like, please, Lord. Since you got money in the bank and you live on 280 now and you got a garden home and they got a community pool and you feel like because the whole family come to your house on Christmas, you the successful one out the family, you sitting your bougie self in here like, please, Lord. Nah, but this brother about to die. And I want you to read this scripture not like you about to die, but like something you believe in is about to die. Hezekiah don't say, please, Lord. Hezekiah said, please. 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 I stood in the L.I. Hall when we only had 8 members. Hello, Rod, no music. We only had 8 members, and I would have to get there early to mop because they would have social savings parties before church. And I would get there about 5 in the morning and sweep up stuff and mop up needles. And I'd be so tired by the time church started. We didn't have any members. And one day I had prayed, I had fasted, and my gut said, this is going to be a good Sunday right here. And nobody came. And I can remember after we set up, I was defeated. I was broken. And something about my desperation just said, please, Lord. And I'm not preaching to everybody. I'm only preaching to 7 of y'all who desperate. I don't know who I'm preaching to. Like that woman with the issue of blood. Y'all can talk about me. Y'all can look at me like I'm crazy. But if I gotta crawl, if I gotta scratch, if I gotta fight, I'm leaving here with something. I don't know who I'm preaching to. I didn't stand in that line just to come in here. I ain't parked 3 blocks away just to come in here. Truth be told, I ain't come to see you, Pastor Mike, because you can't heal my body. But for the next 30 seconds, I got to please in my spirit. Please, 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 please do it for me. And I thank God for this new school music. But granddaddy, at the old school church, it would be 10 grown men standing across the front. They didn't know how to do runs, but they knew how to call on God. And they would say, please, 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 please. And they would just call on Jesus. And I would be in the back of the church like, I wish they shut up. Now I got 5 kids. And I'm scared that they may go outside and not make it home just because of the color of their skin. I got real pain. And I don't know what you're going through, but for the next 30 seconds, you ought to release a desperate worship. Please. Please. I pray for you. You pray for me. And watch God change. You don't know the strength your neighbor got left. Look at him and say, I pray for you. You pray for me. Can you sing that, Terrell? Watch God.
And watch God change. I pray for you. You pray for me. And watch God change me.
Can you just grab your neighbor by the hand right there and just declare that I pray for you, say,
I pray for you.
I remember when he saved my life.
Everything before that was just a blur. I was wild, living real foul. I just wasn't right.
No.
I remember when he changed my name from Ezekiel, from broke the bless. Now I can testify that I will never be the same. Can we worship Rock City? Lift it up. Trying to figure out how I'm going to take care of these babies. I'm pregnant with a vision, but I don't know how God going to do it. And you know when you go to the bankruptcy, they talk to you like you a dog. They make you tell all your business in front of an open room. I would come on the radio and give $50 away every Friday on 95.7. And didn't even... I'm giving $50 away on Friday and my power out at my house.
I did a gas giveaway and everybody in the city got gas. And that night I ran out of gas and they had to come get me. Cause it was... See, it's one thing to pray. It's another thing to see your prayer get answered. And I don't know who I'm preaching to, but I speak God's about to answer the prayer you forgot you prayed. I don't know who I'm preaching to, but I decree and declare that the devil is a liar. Hear me. When God put this church in my spirit, we didn't have much. My daddy gave me his name. Every man, you should have got excited about that. Because my dad didn't give me $1 million. He would if he could have. He would have gave me everything I needed in life if he could have. But he gave me something. And every man in this room ought to receive this. He said, I can give you my name. So there were days when my pocket couldn't do it. But because I had a daddy with a good name. Hear me. It was people in my life like Carol Smith who helped me buy some speakers from a pawn shop. And the first speakers we put in the church was these little speakers from a pawn shop right there in East Lake. People believe in you. And my prayer for every person watching me in this room and everybody watching online is that we don't become superficial Christians. Hear me? Hear me. I don't do this for recognition. My name isn't on one building we got. You don't pull up to a church and it say Rock City Church, Michael D. McClure Jr. Pastor. Because it was never about me. And as I look out this room today, I don't see people. Help me, God. I see answered prayers. And I don't know who's going to receive this, but God's shifting you from needing a prayer answered. I hope seven of y'all catch this. You are about to be the answer to somebody's prayer. Where's Pastor Hollis? Help Pastor Hollis come here. So hear me. When I say God is amazing, I'm not telling you what I heard, bro. From exit 133, Kilgo Memorial, the Ramada Inn. You can pay by the week and stay there. Hear me, I done woke up in there some nights. God is amazing. To have nothing, God is amazing. And I don't know who I'm speaking to, but somebody in your spirit just said, it's on now. What just happened? I pray seven of y'all can receive this because I need you to put this scripture on the screen, Dre. It says, please, Lord, remember how I served you faithfully with the whole heart. I was committed and I carried out your will. Then he began to weep. He didn't just cry. He began to weep. But look at the next scripture. I feel God on me. The Lord, watch this, message came to Isaiah. Next scripture. Look at what it says. Look at what it says. Go tell Hezekiah. This is what the Lord God of your ancestors, David, says. Here's enough to tear the whole church up. You don't need a promise. You don't need a breakthrough. I'm not going to tell you some money coming. Here's a word for 1,000 of y'all. I heard your prayers. I don't know who's been praying and feeling like God's not going to do it. God told me to tell you, I heard. Watch this. I heard your prayers. I seen your tears. Michael, look. I will add, listen to this. It's on the screen. 15 years to your life. But that ain't the shout. That ain't the shout, Pastor. That's not the shout. See, this is where most people stop. I got 15. But I'm not selfish. Because Colleen, here's the next verse. He says, watch this. I will also rescue you and this city. Y'all missed what I just said. Now I got to ask y'all a question. Did the city pray? One person prayed. The whole city got delivered. I'm going to say it to this side. They sleep over there. One person prayed. The whole city. Y'all still sleep. I'm going to talk to y'all. One person prayed. the whole city got delivered. I wonder what would happen if Legacy Arena prayed. I wonder what would happen if we would touch and agree. I declare our school system is blessed. Our police officers are covered. Our children are covered. Our systems are fixed. Every need is met. Birmingham is blessed. West End is blessed. Ansley is blessed. The East Side is blessed. Greater Birmingham is blessed. You are the shout.
Pastor Hollins, I feel God leading us to do this today. Y'all, somebody grab Pastor Hollins. Somebody grab Pastor Hollins. Y'all step over here for me. Grab Pastor Hollins. I have heard your prayers. I have seen your tears. Hear me. Is your father here? Hear me. Do we got any anointing oil here? Hear me. Yes, God. Come up here with me, Pastor D. I want to... How many years you been here? 2012, you walked in the church. Gifted, anointed. And I looked at you and said, well, go in the parking lot. Every church wanted you to be a part of their ministry. And I'm the only person saying, nah, go in the parking lot. I sent you to the parking lot, not because I ain't see nothing in you. But one day God gonna elevate you. Watch this. And if you don't have the heart of a servant, any leader that does not know how to be submissive will be abusive when in authority. That's why our mayor is so dope. That's why our leaders are so dope, is because they know how to submit. They don't have to bully. They don't have to play games. This is why I try to stay low and humble, because God said, watch this, whatever you do, God will do the opposite. If you exalt yourself, he'll humble you. But if you humble yourself, he'll exalt you. I want to lay hands on you. I want you to face church. Pastor Darius, Elise, can you come stand next to him? As we celebrate 13 years, this is member number one. Freshman, hear me. A freshman in college, the first person to ever join our church. That was 14 years ago. I want to lay hands on you because God is anointing you two for an assignment. Hear me when I say this. Father, in the name of Jesus, we as a church stretch our hands towards you. And I release a pastoral anointing over them. God, I decree and declare that by 2024, the ministry that is in them, the gifting that's in them will rise. The anointing will go to another level. God, I pray what the Bible says, a double portion. Ooh, I wish I had a prayer warrior somewhere. I pray for a double portion of anointing. More favor, more wisdom, more discernment, more grace. God, I come against anything that seeks to deter him from being who you called him to be. God, I'm so good. I'm so grateful that your goodness and your mercy, the Bible says, it chases us. You said, God, it chases us. God, I'm grateful because that means every lie, every rumor, every past mistake is trying to hunt me, but grace and mercy is hunting it. So in this moment, God, we ask that you release a double portion of anointing on their life. God, I speak grace over her, wisdom over her. God, I pray right now that every place that may have been hurt or wounded is healed. God, I pray that she leads from a pure heart. God, let her know that we're proud of her, that we love her. That God, if her father never says it, God, we believe in her. God, that if friends don't encourage, we stand with her. God, I lift him up right now, that he won't be chasing ghosts. That God, he won't have the pressure of trying to live up to what I did, or the pressure of trying to be known. God, let him be impactful. God, I decree and declare. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on them. For you serve faithfully. Rock City, we're getting ready to send them on an assignment. We've been saying this, and we're going to start living up to it. Montgomery never going to be the same because of Destiny City. Hear me when I say this. But we release them into purpose. We release them into an assignment that's so much larger than them. If you don't mind, church, can you stretch your hand this way? My God is able. Is a liar. And see, I want to free you, and always learn from your pastor. We speak curses into people's life. We say stuff like this: it's gonna be hard, it's gonna be difficult. Don't speak your experience over nobody. Myself, Amir Woofin, Crystal, Clint, we stand on the shoulders of a Roger and a Carol Smith, over a Kincaid, over Bell. If it wasn't for my granddaddy being beat in the street across the street, I wouldn't be standing in this arena. So hear me, because of you, seven of y'all ought to get excited. Everything that come after me, the struggle is over. You ought to just speak a blessing over your whole bloodline right there. I don't know what my last name meant before I got here, but I speak it's going to be greater when I leave here. I don't speak overflow. You ought to just slap five people, I high five and tell them it's coming. God can do exceedingly, yeah, abundantly, above. God can do exceedingly. So we don't birth struggles. I'm going to say that again. We don't birth struggles. So I speak and I announce to the world. Hear me. See, in the old school church, you had to leave mad. We don't leave mad. We send you blessed. Hear me. Hear me. I speak by faith. I want to present to some and introduce to others. All right. For the first time, that in 2024, you were looking at the pastor and first lady of One City Church, Nashville. I need y'all to shout, Rock City Church, give it up for One City Church. Nashville will never be the same. Somebody shout! Hear me? Nashville, look at that. One City Church. Go to Rock City Church for me, Dre. So now we got Rock City, we have Destiny City, and now we have what? One City. If you're anywhere near the Nashville area, if you got family, we don't birth struggles. Let me tell you what happens. This is the part of his ministry where he struggles, he tries to get it off the ground, got to figure out how he's going to feed his family. For the next year, we're going to cover your salary at the church. Just don't worry about it. We don't birth struggles. Somebody say amen. Your first three services, your church going to pay for all that. Don't worry about that. Hear me. Y'all got to find somewhere to live. On behalf of our family, that deposit done. That's your pastor's blessing. We don't birth. I bind struggle in the African-American community. We will be a generation that leaves inheritance. Look at your neighbor and say, inheritance, inheritance, blessings, breakthrough, favor, joy. So listen, if you're watching me right now from all over the world and you're anywhere in Nashville, I want you to text We Are One. Do this sound familiar? To 28950. Why, Pastor Mike? We are binding generational curses of competition, and we are releasing collaborative efforts where the favor of God will rest, rule, and abide. Pastor Mike, how his first service gonna look? He only knows one person in Nashville as of right now, and that's his sister-in-law. But Pastor Mike, how they gonna do it? I tell you, if we gotta get on a bus on Sunday morning and take an old school Baptist trip with some Faygo and some cold chicken, we gonna go there, I preach online and they can watch online, and we gonna get on the bus, we gonna sing songs on the bus, and when he walk in, if we gotta put on some One City shirts, like, hey, how you doing? We are One City. You know, I'm really Rock City. I'm just helping Pastor Hollis out in Jesus' name. Why PMJ? Because we do not birth struggles. And I speak by faith that the struggle over your family, over your bloodline, over your children, I want to present a song. This is going to be funny because he's going to be on Devo Energy in the morning. I want to present a song, Pastor Hollis of One City Church. Kinley, so this your best. Oh my Lord. Oh, this a blessing, baby. It's okay. They best friends in Jesus' name. Oh Lord.
I'm sorry, y'all. None of this is gonna come out the way. Kind of plan. God, come on, boy, get it together. Okay. All right, okay. You sort of plan the way you want to say stuff. And I think what God wanted to make super clear to everybody here today, myself included, is that my heart has belonged to this place since I was 22 years old. And I haven't done I haven't done it all right. I haven't dotted every I, haven't crossed every T. But Rock City, Pastor Mike, Lady, First Family, I have given this thing everything that I have. We've grown up here. And I don't know if you guys really realize what I'm saying when I say that. But you guys have given us the ability to make mistakes and not judge us for it, not throw us away. You've allowed us and given us space to grow into what God has called us to be. And I can never say thank you enough for what that's meant to me and to my family. Having Ava cry, McKinley, they're best friends. This isn't a job for us. This wasn't just something cool to do. This was family. This is an assignment. We bleed Rock City. Y'all not hear what I'm saying? Pastor Mike, I'll never be able to thank you enough. I'll never be able to say thank you enough. The chance, the opportunity, the faith, the belief to just ride shotgun. Just to ride shotgun, man. So many memories. I remember, I'm sorry too, but I want to say this because so many times my friends are here, I got, you know, people who are here, and so many times people ask questions, and those of you who serve in ministry, y'all get this, like, how is he? What kind of person is he? And I tell people that he's the person who rode down the highway with me in a beat up 2007 Nissan Altima with no headlights. It's a true story, y'all. And I was so embarrassed and ashamed to have him in the car, and he just made the whole thing a joke. And she just reminded me, I ran out of gas in y'all driveway one time. And I ain't never heard you mention it. I've never heard you ridicule me. He just, hey man, go get you some gas. And that has taught me that you can get everything you've ever dreamed, hoped, or imagined from God, and it not change who you are. Can y'all help me celebrate the most amazing, incredible senior pastor in the world? Come on, y'all go crazy. Let's honor him. Let's love on him. And I just pray that, I pray that we can do half in Nashville what Rock City has done in Birmingham. Rock City, we love you. We are
Rock City. I just want to say that I love you and Lady J so much. As you all know, I was the first member. I remember coming in. We came early, and there wasn't nobody there. So, okay, some people going to come. And I looked back, and nobody wasn't there. But even that, literally that first service, I joined the church because it was just something about it. And you all see what he do now, but it's been like that literally since the first day. And I remember at the LR Hall how you used to walk around the building for church start or Bible study. We would have church in a circle, which we can't do that now. But it was just amazing just how far that you all have come. And you all have been, where you at? You all have been in our lives so much. You all have been such a blessing. I don't know what I would do without you guys. Like, you are the best godparents, our girls. I don't know how Ava gonna go with us. She probably gonna be stuck at y'all house. I'm just joking, but I just wanna say that I love y'all so much, and we're still gonna be here. You all still our pastor, our first lady. We ain't going nowhere. We just gonna be in another city. But I just wanna say I love y'all so much.
And we celebrate them right there. Well, listen, Rock City, happy anniversary. Happy anniversary. If you're watching online, we want to give you an opportunity. Here's my dream. I told God, it's not a dream, a prayer request. I told God, I said, we coming in hot this year. Here's a good place to clap. As of today, over 800 people have given their life to Jesus at Rock City Church. So maybe, thank y'all so much, maybe you're here and you don't know Jesus. I want you to pull your phone out and text HOME to 28950. HOME to 28950 so you can give. Yeah, hear me, hold on. Amen. Also, as we raise a soul, I want to say this too. We have people who travel here just because, I need you to catch this, they want to see if they're qualified to give our minister of music a kidney. I don't know where you are. Where are you? Right here? Oh, where? I don't know where you are. I don't know where you are. But listen, they're right there. There you are. Bless Jesus in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, we're going to pray that all of that comes back well. Somebody shout, that's already done in Jesus' name. Hear me. Every time we're going to keep, Pastor Mike, why do you keep posting that? It's because that's what we want to do. And I told my team, I said, we're going to create ministry not based off of what culture says we need. We don't need a number three usher board. No, we need a health ministry. We need to make sure we got stuff that's relevant. So listen, I'm so excited. If you're giving today, you know how to give. You can text iRock with the amount you wish to give to 28950. I need your help. I want to make the devil mad. If you haven't downloaded the new, who's enjoying the new album so far? Anybody? Did we do that thing? I'm excited, man. It was one of the most stressful times for me because I wrote basically 90% of it, you know, and I just really, really wanted to put my heart and soul into it, and I could not have done it without the people you see standing behind me, from Adia, who shuts it down, to Terrell, to Steven, to Wateria, to Amanda, Curtis, who helped arrange some of the vocals in studio, from Rod to every producer, to every person who's a part of the project. And I'm going to be thanking them for the rest of this year. I just want to say thank you. Do me a favor. If you haven't downloaded it yet, what does download mean? $11.99. What my $11.99 saints said? Throw your hands up. All right, so do me a favor. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, let me see your phone real quick. All right, open the album for him. That's what I need you to do. Open your phone, go to iTunes right now. If it don't say purchase next to it, slap their phone on that ground right there. All this worshiping, we're going to fight now. Slap the phone on the ground right there. No, but seriously, let me show you what we are close to doing. Let me show you. As of right now, Pastor James, I don't know where Pastor James is at. He's good at looking at the charts. Where are we on the world? So let me show you what's happening right now. When the album dropped, it was the number two most downloaded album in the whole world. So hear me when I say that. The only person in front of us was Shania Twain. So hear me, man. So right now, if 50 of you would go on iTunes and just download it for $11.99, do me a favor. If you have a child who you bought a phone, take their phone and download it for them. It's your money anyway, in Jesus' name. Amen. So do me a favor. Go to your child phone. Download it for $11.99. $99 right now. If you ask me for a hug in a minute, the first thing I'm gonna say before I hug you, I'm not checking vaccination cards, I'm checking downloads in Jesus' name. So when you walk up to me and be like, hey, Pat, hey, let me see your phone. Well, I know I don't have iPhone. God bless you. I can't hug you this weekend. I'm only hugging downloaded people this weekend in Jesus' name. Ask your neighbor, are you downloaded? I need to know if you're downloaded. To everyone who came from across the country, if you came from somewhere, just shout wherever you are right there. Shout your city out wherever you at. Are you ready? So listen, I love you so much. I'm praying for you. Did y'all enjoy yourself today? Was it fun? Did we do some preaching and some singing? We got not moved. All right, man. So y'all stand to your feet with me. I'm finna pray us out of here. I guess we can party a little bit on the way out, okay? Hold on right quick. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for keeping us this far, and I speak by faith. Devil, you ain't seen nothing yet. I speak by faith that not only are we going to Nashville, it's another ministry in our church, and it's another ministry in our church. And I speak by year 15, God, we just won't be blessing ministries, we'll be blessing businesses. I speak franchises over some of them right now. God, I speak jobs and better jobs, raises and bonuses, sales and commission by faith. everything is coming to us now. And God, I thank you in advance. I pray a special prayer. Lord, your will, nothing more, nothing less, nothing else. It's in Jesus' name. Now, I want to do something before you leave. The first anniversary we had, we took a church picture and the whole church fit in the picture. Can I take a picture with my church today? Is that okay? All right, so I don't know. I don't have a phone. I just want to take a picture. T.O., I don't know where T.O. is. I don't know. Can I see your phone? I just want to take me a picture with my church. Dre got this. Look at, that's the first church anniversary. Right there. Y'all see that? That's the whole church. Them the boys right there. So I'm excited. So I'm going to just take a picture. I hope y'all can fit. Yeah, that ain't going to work. Jesus Christ. 0.5. There it is. See, all right, so y'all ready? We're going to do it on the count of three. I just want y'all to say, y'all ready? Uh-oh. Jeez, there's so many of y'all. You up there in the back. Scoot over just a little bit. You know who I'm talking to. Move. Jesus Christ. Wait. There we go. Terrell, why are you in the picture posing so strong? Terrell, there they go. There he, Jesus Christ. Okay, wait. Ready? What's up, everybody? Happy anniversary! We are! If you're doing it big in 2023, and you know God, get ready to blow your mind, you ought to make some noise! Let's go! Let's go! Happy anniversary! Everybody just sing with me! Say, God is a big guy. God is a big guy. God is a big guy.
I believe.
You ought to sing if you still believe it.
That it's my season.
He kept us in the midst of it all, so I still believe.
And I believe.
Yeah, that it's my time.
That it's my time.
Yeah.
It's my time.
If you're doing it big, let's go. Breakthroughs in the room. It's yours if you want it. I'm anticipating. Fill up, God's getting
good.
Yeah.
God's getting ready.
I need y'all to rock with me. Y'all ready? Before I do. God, He works. Yeah. Keep us another 10, and it's gonna be, yeah. God is a big guy.
God is a big guy.
Can we swag and surf Rock City? Let's go. Yeah. Won't even try. And it's gonna be. That is gonna be. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, you better stick close to me. Cause favor is about to overtake my whole section. You ought to shout like it's already yours. I love y'all. Can we declare that together? Said, I believe, yeah, that it's my season, come on, we get ready to go home, and
I believe,
yeah, that it's my time, yep,
it's my time,
and I can feel it,
breakthrough.
need one big choir. Said I can feel it.
I can feel it.
Joy's in the room.
Joy's in the room.
Come on, I need y'all help. Come on. Said I can feel it.
I can feel it.
Get on top of it and shout favor.
Favor.
I'm anticipating. God's getting ready to move.
God's getting ready to move.
No music at all. For I know.
For I know that my time is worth a miracle just for me.
And it's gonna be. Tell the devil, get behind me. So I open up my windows and let your blessings flow on through. When I think about your goodness, I just can't help but move. I need y'all dancing with me. Let's go.
But you got me dancing all around.
And I don't care who sees, so I'm gonna move my feet.
And around.
the band up. Go! Last time, y'all ready? Open up the windows right here. No music set.
Open up the window and let your blessings follow me.
No music.
Open up the window and let your blessings follow me.
Let me hear you say.
This is so, Rock. Go so good, Rock. Cut it up.
Said you shouldn't judge a book by its cover, call me lucky. Only still alive, cause he's so good. Yeah, he turned my morning into dancing, not laughing. Telling everybody that he's so good.
If you only knew where I started from, you would understand my praise.
You would understand my praise.
Catching up on all the things he's done. Yeah, we got it out the mud.
Came from nothing.
Only
with my church present, but Rod, I'm about ready to do my thing. Cut the stem up. I said, I'm about ready to do my thing.
We ready?
Let's go.
I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Hey, hey, hey.
I got a feeling everything's gonna be alright.
Y'all go dance with me.
Gonna be alright.
Yeah.
doing. Tell him I'm pointing my blessing. Everything gonna be all right. You say it. I know everything gonna be all right. You.
I know everything gonna be all right.
Let me hear you say it. Everything gonna be all right. You say, I know.
I know. Everything gonna be all right.
You say, I know.
I know. Yeah. Everything gonna be all right.
Yeah, I know. Everything gonna be alright. Good evening, y'all. Everything gonna be alright. Hey,
now.
Everybody jump, say I know.
cuatro, cinco, seis. You know, I'm counting my blessings. Counting my blessings.
Come on.
shouldn't judge a book by its cover. Call me lucky. I'm still alive because he's so good.